Hi students, in this video I am going to telling you about chlorophyce. Algae are divided into three main classes. They are chlorophyce, pheophyce and rhodophyce. Now we are going to discuss about chlorophyce. Chlorophyce class commonly called green algae. Why? Because in the chlorophyce members, they have the pigments chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Due to the pigments chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B, they are in appearing grass green color. So they are called green algae. Next, plant body. Plant body of the chlorophyce is unicellular or colonial or filamentous. Unicellular means single cell. If the plant body have only one cell. Next, colonial. Unicellular example Chlamydomonas. Colonial means in some Volvox species, thousands of Volvox cells combined together to form one colony. Look at the picture. See the picture of Volvox. Thousands of cells combine together to form colony. Each cell in the colony is connected by cytoplasmic extensions. Next, this is the Chlamydomonas. This is the example of unicellular chlorophyce member. Chlorophyce members are photosynthetic. They can prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. The shape of the chloroplast in the chlorophyce is discoid or plate-like or reticulate or cup-shaped or spherical or ribbon-shaped in different species. They store the food material in the pyrenoids. These pyrenoids are located in the chloroplasts. The pyrenoids contain not only the protein but also starch. In some algae, the food is stored in the form of oil droplets also. These chlorophyce members have rigid, means strong and rough cell wall. Strong and tough cell wall. These cell wall contain two layers, inner layer and outer layer. Inner layer is made up of cellulose, outer layer made up of pectose. Next, we can see reproduction. Reproduction takes place in three methods in chlorophyce. That is, first one is vegetative reproduction, second one is asexual reproduction, and third one is sexual reproduction. Now we can see vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction in the chlorophyce takes place by fragmentation. If the plant body cut or get separated into some parts, each portion have capacity to give a new plant. So each portion of the plant body became a new plant. These type of reproduction is called fragmentation. Next, asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction takes place by flagellated juice spores. These juice spores have flagella, so the juice spores move with the help of flagella. The juice spores are produced in the juice sporangia. Next, sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction in the chlorophyce take place by isogamous type. Sexual reproduction in the chlorophyce members are three modes. First one is the isogamous, and second one is the anisogamous, and third one is the oogamous type. First one we see isogamous type. Isogamous type of reproduction, both male and female gametes are same. We can't identify them, which is male gamete and which is female gamete. So they are similar in size and morphology. Next, anisogamous. Anisogamous is opposite to the isogamous. We can identify the gametes, which is male and which is female. Male gamete is small in size, female gamete is big in size. Next to oogamy. Oogamy type of reproduction, male gamete is mobile, that mobile means male gamete can move, female gamete immobile, female gamete can't move. So this is the reproduction of the chlorophysae. Examples of chlorophysae: Volvox, Eulothrix, Spirogyra and Cara. Now I am asking some questions to you from chlorophysae. First one is the plant body of chlorophysae: A. Unicellular, B. Colonial, C. Filamentous, D. All above. Answer this D. The plant body of the chlorophysae: unicellular or colonial or filamentous. D. Second was chlorophysae contain the pigments. A. Chlorophyll A, B. Chlorophyll B, C. A and B, D. Chlorophyll D. C is the right answer. Next, pyrenoids of the chlorophysae contains only starch, only protein, A and B, lipids. B is the correct answer. A and C, starch and protein. Next, mode of the reproduction in chlorophysae: vegetative, asexual, sexual, all above. D is the correct answer. Which of the following not belongs to chlorophysae: Eulothrix, Spirogyra, Chlamydomonas, Cara? Yes, Spirogyra. In the next video, we can discuss about Phaeophysae and Rhodophysae.